Hi, I'm Forrest Carr, the Bashful Bloviator with Tucson's Power Talk 1210 Radio. Well, now we know. If you are a man and you walk up to a woman on the street and say hello, then you are a sexual harasser. You have just committed an act of sexual harassment, one that could even be a precursor to gender-based violence. Now, we all owe the activist website, ihollaback.org, a tremendous debt of gratitude for bringing this problem to the public's attention. And now that our eyes have been opened, the question is, where do we go from here? What are we going to do about this? To answer that, it might be useful to go back and examine what exactly led us to the sorry state of affairs in which we now find ourselves.
Hey, woman.
This is the guy who did this to us, the late Roy Orbison. Oh, he didn't do it alone. His 1964 smash hit, Pretty Woman, is not the only song out there promoting sexual harassment or glorifying the act of men sexually objectifying women. Do I Diddy, She's About a Mover, Hey Good Looking, Venus in Blue Jeans, Baby's Got Her Blue Jeans On, Honky Tonk Badonkadonk, I Like Big Butts, and so on, spring to mind. But Pretty Woman pretty much is the king of these. So, let's deconstruct a few lines and see if we can set things right, shall we?
Pretty woman walking down the street.
See, now right here, the singer is already off course for two reasons. The first is the use of the word pretty. This inappropriately excludes the dozens, perhaps hundreds, of others on the street who also have the right to feel good about their bodies. Victoria's Secret got into trouble for this very thing just recently. Critics rightly pointed out that its current The Perfect Body bra campaign unfairly holds up for praise only those models with slim body types. The second problem with this lyric is the word woman. In today's enlightened society, we now know that there are dozens of genders, and that just because someone has the appearance and dress of a female, it does not mean that he or she is a female or identifies as one. It is the right of every individual to make these kinds of personal choices. It's simply wrong to make assumptions about anyone based on physical appearance. In every case, the only correct thing to do is to address the person the way he or she wishes to be addressed. And to do that, you have to know that person's preference. Since the singer has not been introduced to the pedestrian, and since we now know, thanks to Hollaback.org, that self-introductions constitute sexual harassment, then the approaching person's gender identity has to remain a question mark throughout the song.
Pretty woman, the kind I like to meet.
Clearly, the singer is now contemplating the possibility of verbally or even physically approaching the pedestrian, which, as we have noted, would be very inappropriate.
I don't believe you. The truth.
Although it's not clear exactly where the singer is going with this, it seems that he's having some kind of reaction to the pedestrian's dress or appearance, which really is none of his business. This sets the stage for inappropriate thinking and behavior, up to and possibly including an invasion of the pedestrian's privacy and personal space.
No one could look as good as you.
This continues the inappropriate thinking already noted above in the discussion about the word pretty, and expands it. Clearly, the singer is now having a sexual fantasy. Given that thoughts are father to the deed, this is very dangerous thinking that could lead to inappropriate actions.
Mercy.
It's not clear here whether the singer is merely thinking the word mercy or has spoken it aloud. And if the latter, whether he has done so within earshot of the pedestrian. If so, it's a catcall and is way over the line. If the former, it's dangerous thinking that could lead to a catcall, and therefore it's equally unacceptable.
Pretty woman, won't you pardon me?
Okay, now he's done it. As predicted, he intercepted the pedestrian, which is very wrong of him to do. He's taken the first step towards gender violence.
I couldn't help but see, pretty woman, and you look lovely as can be.
Now he's continuing and expanding his inappropriate behavior by making unsolicited comments clearly of a personal and sexual nature. But wait, it gets even more invasive.
Are you lonely and just like me?
Another unsolicited personal question. And the implication here is repulsive. If she's lonely, he's the cure? How disgusting can you get? But wait, it gets still worse. That word is printed as wow in some web versions of the lyrics, and it's omitted in others. In the song, it sounds like the singer's attempt to imitate the growl of a tomcat. It's a catcall, and it's clearly inappropriate. But he's not done yet, not by a long shot.
Pretty woman, stop a while. Pretty woman, talk a while.
This is the exact kind of inappropriate harassing behavior documented in the iHollaback.org video, where we see a creepy guy following the actress, pestering her to stop and talk and so on.
Pretty woman, give your smile to me.
Again, we saw this exact form of harassment in the video, where someone called out a request for a smile as the woman walked by. That lyric and the one before it are clear and unconscionable examples of sexual harassment. Behavior the singer is glorifying.
Pretty woman, say you'll stay with me.
Does he mean stay and talk? Or is he suggesting something more? This is a borderline solicitation.
I need you. I'll treat you right.
What does he mean by I need you and I'll treat you right? This statement, while not explicit, seems very sexual in nature and therefore is absolutely inappropriate.
Come with me, baby.
Come with him? Really? He's physically intercepted the pedestrian and now is proposing to take her, or him, somewhere? And where does he get off calling the pedestrian baby? In a worst-case scenario, this could be a precursor to kidnapping and violence. Even so, the singer doesn't make it explicitly clear what his intentions are. But don't worry, he will. It's about to move out of the murky realm of implication and suggestion and right out into the light, bringing his sexual predilections into full view.
Be mine tonight.
And there it is, a clear solicitation for sexual favors. This could and should get you arrested today in some jurisdictions. Hopefully, in the not too distant future, such behavior will be illegal everywhere.
Pretty woman, don't walk on by. Pretty woman, don't make me cry.
He might cry. Really? Here it's getting pathetic. If he's invading her personal space while making these pleas, as we saw men doing in the iHollaback.org video, it's also frightening.
Don't walk away, hey.
This is more harassment, just like the kind we saw in the video. These unwanted overtures can be unsettling, even scary, especially if the harasser is pacing the victim down the sidewalk.
I guess I'll go on home, it's late.
Okay, so he's giving up, right? But don't relax. What he's about to say next is truly frightening.
There'll be tomorrow night.
The implications here are staggering. The harasser does this kind of thing every night, and no one has raised a finger to stop it. Local authorities and society at large are unconscionably uninvolved and detached, continuously allowing this behavior to go unchallenged. Where is our humanity? Where is our outrage?
Is she walking back to me? Yeah, she's walking back to me.
We are supposed to believe that the behavior we just witnessed, which is a shock to the conscience of every right-thinking person, will win him sexual favors? Really? Again, this is just pathetic. About as realistic as the opening overtures of a porn scene, and just as unacceptable in a public setting. Now, let's see if we can fix this. Here are some new lyrics that remove the sexual harassment and the wrong thinking. And I won't try to sing this, I'll just recite it. Approaching person who has the general physical and dress characteristics of a female, but whose gender self-identity is not yet known, walking down the street. approaching person who has the general physical and dress characteristics of a female, but whose gender or self-identity is not yet known. The kind I'd like to have someone introduce me to. Approaching person, I wonder how you self-identify. Approaching person, and that's about as far as the song will be able to go and remain within the bounds of appropriate thinking and behavior. Also, to accommodate the new words, the underlying music will need some adjustment, as will our thinking. Thanks for listening. Please donate to ihollaback.org today. Together, we can stamp out the problem of men saying hello to women in our lifetimes.